In other news, Hobby Lobby went before the U.S. Supreme Court today, or yesterday, and argued that as a corporation, they should be able to exercise their religion. Have we gone nuts?
Well, yeah, we have, but the reason the right wing has gone nuts is because they realize that they have a majority, a Republican majority on the Supreme Court that is nuts. And they realize there's nothing too crazy for a Scalia. There's nothing too far out there for a Clarence Thomas. They know they can sell these kinds of things. The interesting edge about this case is you have consumers that should pray. They should be on their knees praying that this court does allow constitutional protection for a corporation. You know why? Because if they do that, it's another brick in the wall that says that a corporation is a person. And therefore, when a corporation commits a crime or when a corporation makes a product that kills people, you not only can sue the corporation, but you can sue the CEO and you can sue the shareholders, because the separateness, the veil that's supposed to protect the corporation from the individual, has been broken. And I promise you this, Tom, if there's any dicta in that decision, that Hobby Lobby decision, you're going to have lawyers all over this country suing not only the corporation, but suing the owners of the corporation. The first thing you would do, the next slip and fall case that takes place at Hobby Lobby, they'll not only sue Hobby Lobby, they will sue Mr. and Mrs. Green, who brought this case to the Supreme Court, because there is no distinction between Mr. and Mrs. Green and the corporation. And that's the only protection they have. It allows them to avoid bankruptcy issues personally, tort actions personally, civil actions of all kinds, contract disputes personally. All of that protection goes out the window if the Supreme Court goes as far as I think they're capable of going.
Oh, that would be an amazing event.